Hi, hello. Yes, I once again welcome you to the class. Okay, now shall we see? Have you found the answer for that question which I gave you? Yes or no? Okay, if yes, very good. Okay, now shall I tell you? Okay, fine. So, first we will be seeing about the season. Okay, so during which season does this shearing process takes place? It normally they do this process during the month of summer season, during summer seasons. Yes, as I already said you in the first class, they have this outer covering because to protect them from extreme cold. Yes or no? To protect them from extreme cold. Yes, so in summer, if the shearing process is done, they will be free. Yes, they will be free from sweat. So within winter, these hairs will grow again and it will be helpful for them to protect from the cold. Yes, so it is done in summer and these hairs would again grow within winter. Okay, so one more question is, do they feel pain during the process of shearing? Yes, do they feel? Yes or no? Yes, but no, they don't feel the pain. Have you seen your father shaving their beards? Yes or no? Do they feel painful? No. Have you cutted your nails? Do you feel pain? No. It will be like that only for them. So it does not feel any pain because it will be only there like shaving off their beards. Only shaving of their hairs. Clear? Shall we go to the next? Yes. The second process is scouring. Scouring. What is mean by this? So, the process of washing of sheared skin with hair in tanks to remove any kind of dust, dirt or grease is called scouring. What is that? The process of washing this sheared skin. So there may be many dirts inside that, like oil, grease, etc. So to remove all this dirt, they use this process of scouring. Scouring is nothing but washing the sheared skin. Fine? Okay. So see, these are here the scouring process is different. See, these sheared skin are sent through the large tanks which had hot waters. After that, see, this is the sheared hair before scouring and after scouring, how it looks like. Before scouring it looks dirt, but after scouring, see how white it is. Yes, it would be smooth. First one is shearing, that is removing. Second one is washing. Yes, and then sorting. What is mean by this sorting? Have you seen these pictures here? What is it? In this center, it contains all the ball colors of balls. Yes, but they are segregated or separated according to their colors, right? So sorting is nothing but it is the process of separating according to their character or their nature. Okay, sorting is not, it is the first process at the mill is sorting. The first process at the mill is sorting. The fleece is so sorted into grades, that is the soft one they will keep it separate and then the rough one separate according to their categories. They will separate it. Okay, so they sort fibers according to fineness, length and their color also. Okay, few may be pure white, but few may be ash color. So based on their color, length and everything, they used to separate this washed fleece. Okay, and then next one is the burr separation. What is mean by burr first? Burrs are nothing but they are small, softy, fluffy fibers. Fluffy fibers which are present inside the wool. See, this is full of fibers. But here a small round like structure, right? So it will be hard. It will be like stone, small, round. Okay. So this removing process is called as burr separation. This small, see, you are able to see here, right? Small something colored one. So this is called as burrs. They are small. They may be joined together. Okay. They are not free. So these burrs are separated. And this process is called as burr separation. And then shall we see the next one? Yes. Next process is dyeing. What is mean by dyeing is nothing but coloring. Dyeing is nothing but coloring. Okay. So yarn. We may say that fibers which is converted, washed one into yarn. Okay. So it is the process. Dyeing is the process which is done before the cloth is woven, that is before the cloth is made. So in this process they used to make colors to it. They make colors and they may be separated. Before the weaving process these colors are done. It may be according to their need. The colors may be done according to their need. It may be printed with stripes, lines, with checked one. So this process can be done according to their needs. Dyeing is nothing but giving color to the fleece. Fine. So this is the process of dyeing. See here. So these fleeces are colored. Yes or no? So now it is ready. So after that, what is that? Spinning. Spinning is nothing but tying that into a single bunch. So spinning is the process of taking textile fibers and filaments and making them into yarn. So see here, they are separated like, see. So in the spinning, they used to join this and then make it into a single thread like structure. Okay. So for thousands of years, people spun natural fibers into yarn by hand. So this spinning process is done from beyond thousands of years by the people with the help of their hands. But today, spinning involves many machineries. This spinning method involves many machineries. See here, these are all some of the spinning machines. Yes, see, this is the olden type of machine, that is the equipment which is used for the process of spinning. See, they used to rotate it. Have you seen that? Making that coconut waste, right? Coconut hairs into a rope. What is that? Everything is spinning. So by spinning, they used to make that fibers into yarn. That is a thread. Yarn is nothing but thread-like structure. Okay. But nowadays, what do we use? We use machineries. Nowadays, we use machineries for this purpose. Fine. Recap. Now, let me see a recap what we have seen in this lesson. Shall we come from the first? Yes. What is the first method? The first slide, what is that? Shearing. Yes. Shearing, scouring, sorting, burr separation, dyeing and then spinning. So, shearing. See, what is the action which I am doing now? Shearing is removing. Shearing is nothing but removal of the outer hair. That is the covering, body, outer body covering of the sheep is called as shearing. Okay. Then these are some of the tools which is used for shearing. And then scouring, that is nothing but washing to remove dirt stains which are present inside that. So shearing, scouring, that is washing, shearing, scouring. Yes. And then these are all the images which tells you about before and after scouring. You are able to see the difference well, right? So then sorting, that is separation according to their length, color and their nature. So sorting is nothing but to differentiate it. Yes, again shearing, that is scouring. Yes, washing and then sorting. Then burst separation, burst separation, burst. Okay, that they are small fluffy fibers which is need to be removed. Okay, and then so if it is there as it is, we would be inconvenient, we would feel inconvenience while wearing the dresses. Yes, have you seen the big bedspreads and all? Yes, which is very thick. There may be small burrs which are present there. It may, even inside this burrs, there may be small hooks which is from the plant, wastes, spine, everything are present there. So it may heal us. Okay, it may cause injury to us. So these are to be removed. And then dyeing. Dyeing is coloring. What is that? Coloring. And then this is the pictures which represent the process of dyeing. Fine. So spinning. What is that? Next one is spinning. That is making that fibers into a yarn. Yarn is nothing but thread. So this is the traditional equipment which is used, and nowadays we use machines. So now I will doing only the actions. You want to remember and tell me what are all the steps. Shall we go? Yes or no? Yes. First one. Yes, now let me tell right. What is this? Shearing, scouring, yes, and then sorting, burst separation, dyeing and then spinning. Yes, I hope you all would have understood this. If you have any doubts, listen me. If you have any doubts, note it down. Note down your questions and then you may ask me later. Okay. Now, shall we have the self-evaluation test for you? Yes or no? Shall we start? Yeah, you are ready to give me the answers, right? Okay, first one. What are all the steps involved? What are all the steps involved in processing fibers to wool? What are all the steps involved in processing fibers to wool? Yes, first one. Shearing, scouring, sorting, burst separation, dyeing and then spinning. Yeah, very good. And then what is mean by shearing? What is mean by shearing? Yes. Yes, very good. So the process of removing the fleece from the body is called as shearing, right? Okay, fine. And then the person who does this shearing is called as, the person who does this shearing process is called as, yes, very good, shearer. Who is he? Shearer. Okay, and then what is mean by sorting? What is mean by sorting? You may tell the answer in single word. Yes. Sorting is nothing but separation. Sorting is nothing but separation based on their characters or grades. Yes? And then, next one. What is the traditional equipment which is used for spinning? What is the traditional equipment which is used for spinning? Yes? What is that? Wheel. Yes? It is the wheel. We use wheel during the olden days for the spinning to convert these fibers into yarns. Okay. So children, the homework questions will be sent to you through WhatsApp. You just write that in your classwork note. Okay. Thank you for listening to the class.